What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Cesar with Cesar Gets Crypto, and we are talking about Blue Zelle. We had a positive day yesterday, 6%, 6.4% to the upside, man. This thing does like to crawl when it moves up, though, so I mean, that's not saying too much. I mean, sometimes we have a big pop, but anyways, we moved up 6%. After I was calling for us to go down, it looked like we were slipping. I think literally I made my bearish call on this 4-hour candle right here. And that was like literally the reversal point. So gotta love that. Gotta love seeing that literally being proven wrong, like right in front of my face. But ultimately, I think I will be proven right. You know, I've had a couple of you comments on how well I've been navigating this, and you know, I appreciate it. But moments like this are needed, because you can't always be right, man. You can't. So my correctness timer has reset. Now I've got like 5 in a row that I can call. I'm going to use one of them on this. I think we're going lower. I think this was just a lower high. Nothing significant, really, from this high to this low. Come on now. Yeah, look at that, man. You literally tipped your 1618. Perfect extension. Ooh, you're finding support, potentially finding support on your 886, which would imply that you go higher. Yeah, that would imply that you go higher. You'd have to close above this 1272, though. If you can close above 12.47 cents on a 4-hour basis, you guys, we might be heading up to about 13.7, if not to 14.16, even higher than that. But that's not that big of a deal. It's really not that big of a deal. You know, that can happen, and things ultimately go lower still. From a high to a low, is that the right one? That's not the right one. Sorry. From a high, or a low to a high, actually. Low to a high, the 236, this red line here, which it's very common to find resistance on your 236. I'll mute this for a second just so you can see it. I guess I can delete it, yeah. Finding support in your 382, moving up to your 236, and finding resistance from there, going lower, right? That's very normal. It is normal also to do stuff like this. You're finding a lower high, you're kind of grinding it out, and then you go lower as well. But I want to throw that back on. Let's see. So if we were to go up to this 2886, 2618, we're still, even if we went up a little higher, we're still below this 236 here. So bringing it back down to the 4-hour. Again, very nice rejection off of the 1618. Literally tipped it. Finding support on the 886, there is hope that there is more upside to go. Yes, you did have kind of increasing volume as you were coming out, but you didn't get the move, man. You didn't get the move. It didn't break you out of this overall prevailing downtrend. I mean, you can clearly see how you're still in it, right? Now, it's possible you could be doing some stuff right now that could take you to the upside. It is possible. This 4-hour RSI does look strong. Gotta say, it was looking weak down here, man, but it's looking strong now. So definitely possible that you could go higher, but I'm not completely convinced that we're done going lower one way or another. I'm still sitting out waiting for things to turn around. The daily RSI, you are still in the bearish area of control. You could turn around from here. Rejecting off of that 1618 like that, you know, could send us lower from here as well, but I'm not really going to be convinced that we're going lower until we close below this 886. Really, closing below that 618 would convince me that we are going lower than this, but I mean, I'm pretty much convinced, so I'm waiting, you know. I don't know if we're going to go higher first and then lower, or if we're going to go lower first, but we'll see. Anyways, that's all I got for you guys. Just a quick little daily update on Blue Zelle. This could be a bull trap. This very well could be a bull trap, so just be aware. And with that, I leave you. So take care. Oh, yep. Take care. Bye-bye.